Welcome everyone to the basics lecture on synapses and muscle. In our last lecture, we learned about neurons, membrane potentials, and how action potentials are propagated down the axon of the neuron. Today, we're going to talk about how signals move from one neuron to the next and how neurons cause a muscle contraction. Here's a close-up of the terminal of one nerve cell synapsing onto the dendrite of another. Use chapter 48 in your textbook to label all the appropriate structures. Now here are the steps of synaptic transmission. First, the presynaptic neuron synthesizes a chemical neurotransmitter and stores it in vesicles in the terminal of the first neuron. Second, an action potential in this presynaptic neuron travels down to the terminal and causes voltage-gated calcium channels to open. Third, calcium flows into the terminal of the axon, which triggers the transport of vesicles to the plasma membrane for exocytosis. Fourth, the neurotransmitter is released into the synaptic cleft. Fifth, the neurotransmitter binds to the ligand-gated ion channel on the membrane of the postsynaptic cell, allowing the flow of ions into or out of the cell. In this way, an electrical signal that travels down one neuron is converted to a chemical signal at the synapse, and then which triggers a second electrical signal in the next neuron. But most synapses are not as simple as a single presynaptic neuron and a single postsynaptic neuron. Most neurons actually have many presynaptic neurons. Each of them may release different neurotransmitters onto the postsynaptic membrane. Excitatory postsynaptic potentials have a depolarizing effect on the postsynaptic membrane. Often, one signal is not enough to bring the neuron to threshold. Shown here, two signals, but neither one reaches threshold. If the EPSPs are close in time, shown here, or close in location, shown here, they can add up to reach the depolarization threshold and cause an action potential. An inhibitory postsynaptic potential will actually cause hyperpolarization, making it harder for that neuron to fire. This image shows an excitatory signal and that causes a depolarization and an inhibitory signal that causes a hyperpolarization. In our last major topic, we'll discuss motor neurons. These do not synapse onto other neurons. Instead, they synapse onto muscle. Let's look at some anatomy and then study some physiology. You'll find this image at the back of chapter 50 in your book. Please pause the video and label the image. This is a close-up of a single muscle cell. We've looked at actin and myosin in an earlier lecture, but here again are the strands of actin, the bundles of myosin. Be sure you know what a Z-line is and an M-line. A single unit of muscle contraction is called a sarcomere. The process of contraction can be shown in this five-step process. We start with myosin at rest, bound to ATP, but unbound to actin. And notice the angle of the motor protein is the already used up position. When ATP hydrolyzes to form ADP and phosphate, shown here, the shape of the head changes and it's ready to now pull on the actin. The myosin head is then able to bind to actin. When ADP and PI is released, this causes the myosin to pull on the actin. And that contracts the muscle. The system will stay in this configuration until another ATP molecule is available. When the ATP binds, the head releases. And the process can repeat as long as ATP and calcium are both available and the muscle still has room to contract. As myosin pulls on the actin, it It brings the Z lines closer together and makes the sarcomere smaller. Myosin can only bind to actin on specific binding sites, shown here as little pits. But these active sites are normally covered over by a regulatory protein called tropomyosin that looks like a long string. If the calcium is present in the cytosol, the calcium binds to a protein called the troponin complex. You can see calcium bound right here. The binding of the calcium causes a conformational change in the tropomyosin that pulls it off the actin binding sites and allows myosin to bind. When myosin can bind, the muscle can contract. But as soon as calcium is gone, the change in troponin complex is removed and the tropomyosin falls back over the active binding sites. So now we can discuss how a muscle contraction is regulated by a signal from a motor neuron cell. There are 7 steps in this process. We'll start at the top of the screen and make our way around. First, an action potential travels down the motor neuron, just like any other sort of neuron, and releases a neurotransmitter called acetylcholine into the synaptic cleft. In step 2, acetylcholine binds to a ligand-gated receptor and allows sodium to enter the muscle cell in the same way it would in a postsynaptic neuron. This depolarizes the muscle plasma membrane and causes an action potential to travel along the membrane of the muscle cell. In step 3, the action potential travels deep into the muscle cell in tubes of plasma membrane, which are called T-tubules. The tubules reach the sarcoplasmic reticulum, which is a specialized smooth ER, and this causes the opening, this action potential causes the opening of calcium channels that are voltage gated in the sarcoplasmic reticulum membrane. When these open, calcium is released out into the cytosol. In step 4, the calcium binds to the troponin complex, pulling the tropomyosin away from the myosin binding sites. See that happening here. And in step 5, myosin is able to bind to the actin, pull to contract the muscle. The muscle contractions continue as long as both ATP and calcium are available. In step 6, the calcium is being pumped immediately back up into the sarcoplasmic reticulum by a calcium pump. When the calcium is gone from the cytosol, the myosin can no longer bind to the actin molecules in step 7, and the muscle returns to its lengthened state. To finish up, you should go to the class website and watch videos on these processes, because they're relatively motion-oriented and the videos will help you understand. This is our last basics quiz. Be sure you can do the following before you take the quiz. Thanks for watching.